So, you want to start a K-pop channel and have no clue where to start and what to do. I'll try helping you by going through the process of making my next video in this video right now and give as much useful information as I can. Because a common question in my DMs and comments is which software I use and if I can help them out making videos. And I'll do exactly that with this video. This will be mainly directed to the people that want to make challenges and games. Not so much these compilations of different idols or groups, but it will still contain useful information if you want to do that. So the first thing you need to do is choose a topic you want the video to be about. I mean, you could just make a video like guess the K-pop song and play like 10 seconds of it. But in my honest opinion, I think it's better to have something special about the video or something that separates your video from other videos, because there are like millions of videos like guess this K-pop song. So I have this huge Excel table with all my stuff I did or want to do, and I've already chosen to do Aramdaur, meaning beautiful. And this is where most of my research is going on colorcodelyrics.com, because it's really easy to search for different keywords within the songs and not only the titles. So I'll just search for Aramdaur. You can also just use the romanization, but some songs might not show up then because of different romanizations. So just copy the lyric out of another song text and you're good to go. At first it will show all songs with Aramdaur in the title and then the songs with Aramdaur in the lyrics. So for example, Monster X Beautiful, Korean name Aramdaur, exactly what I'm looking for. So now I go to my Excel list and just type in Monster X. I mean, there are easily enough Aramdaurs for like 5 or 6 parts, I'd guess. But I'll just choose some kinda easy ones for a simple video to make everything as easy and understandable as possible. So what you wanna do to search for the word you're looking for is just press Ctrl F get the search bar and type in Adam, and down here you have it. So how I try to choose the songs is mostly like I try to have a balance between girl and boy groups, and also try to have a balance between harder to guess and easier to guess, to have songs from every category for everyone. But in this case I try to keep it simple just for you to understand. So to actually use these MVs, you need to download them from YouTube. I'll show you how. So I'll just split my screen like this to have my list here, to have YouTube here, and the download site I use here. I'll link it down below. So just for example, I already have it downloaded, but I'll just go in Monster X Beautiful. Go to it, take the link, paste it here, go to MP4. And now you have to choose yourself if you want to make 720p videos or 1080p, because 1080p will take away more disk space, but it will obviously look better. And I liked it, so I downloaded it 1080p. But if you download all the MVs that aren't available in 1080p, you should choose 720p, because it will otherwise give you an error. Click Convert. Wait for it to convert, it's pretty fast, and just download it. Perfect. Now you can go to the next video, Blooming Days by EXO-CBX. Copy the link, convert next video, MP4, choose a size, convert. And you do that until you have all your MVs downloaded. So now that everything's downloaded, as you can see, 16 items selected. 15 plus the intro, we can go into the editing. But before, I want to say I recommend saving all of the MVs and not deleting every MV after finishing every video. But just if you have the space, it's not too much. As you can see, it's like it's 44 gigs for 609 MVs. That's completely okay in my opinion, and that's in 1080p. So if you are saving and editing in 720p, it's like maybe the half of this? It should be around the half, yeah. So you shouldn't be worrying about this space at all. It's just way more convenient to have all these videos downloaded. So the software I use to edit is VGIS Pro 14, and I really can recommend it to everyone who is new in the video editing, because it's really simple to use and you'll get comfortable in video editing really really fast. Also, there's a Humble Bundle for VGIS Pro right now, and you only have to pay $20 for it. Here, you'll get a bunch of stuff, but that's the only important one. The cool thing about Humble Bundle is you can choose where your money goes to, so if you want to, you can make all of the $20 you pay go to charity and even choose between two charities here. But that's just a cool gimmick. I'm not getting paid for saying this, I promise. So to stop the advertising, let's go back to VGIS Pro. So I will now edit the main part of the video, make it fast forward, and talk about it. So I don't want this to be too specific about VGIS because other people will use other software and especially free software. I link a source for free software down below. Also, you shouldn't feel too overwhelmed by editing software like this, because it always looks harder to make than it actually is. You'll get used to it pretty fast. Making the first video won't be easy because you're completely starting from scratch. But once you finish the first video and you have chosen like the fonts you use and made some presets like for the texts and stuff like that, you can just copy and paste it for every video and copy and paste it again and again and again. So after finishing the first, the second will be faster, and the next one will be even faster and faster and faster and faster, and eventually you will get to a fast and solid workflow. And a general tip I have for making simple CapOp videos like this is to use transitions, but not too crazy transitions. Like just use simple fades or crossfades, or some simple not too distracting transitions, because it's easier to follow. And I think hard cuts in videos about music are also a bit rough, I would say. But that's just my preference and personal opinion. So what I do for every song is, at first I copy and paste the headline and song plus artist from either the last song or the last video, or from a preset I've made, and edit them for the next song. Then I drag in the song, go back on colorcodedlyrics.com and look up where the word, in this case Adam Dao, is. I will cut that part out, copy and paste it 3 times, depending on what kind of video I'm making. Then I'll make 2 or 3 second pauses between the clips and after the last clip, just to give enough time to think about it. And after the guessing part, I'll put in like maximum 15 seconds for the answer part. I'll explain later on why exactly that time frame. Do you want me to make a little basic tutorial where I go deeper into the video editing itself? Keep in mind it will be exclusively for VGIS Pro because that's what I'm using. You can vote in the right upper corner if you want it or not. So how do you actually get an uploadable video out of this? You can't just save it because you'll only get a VGIS save file. You need to render it. And what I like to use is just the default Sony AVC Internet 1080p 30 frames per second. If you're making the videos in 720p, you can just use this one. You don't need to change anything about the settings, so you can just press render and you're good to go. It depends on your computer, but it shouldn't be taking longer than 60 minutes to render it. So there's only one less thing you need to be finished, and that's the thumbnail. I usually go to Pinterest and choose a picture there. Let me just find a usable one. So I think this one is pretty good because it has an pretty much one colored background, so you can extend the background to a 720p picture. Also, a picture like this would be pretty well usable because you can cut this out pretty easily. But I'll take the other one because I don't have to cut it out. So what you want to do is right click the picture and search in Google for the picture, because Pinterest saves the pictures in a smaller size and it just looks worse. Then you just choose the biggest size and download it. Then I open a new Photoshop file with my border I have
made a preset for, and dragged the one in. You can, by the way, just make this in GIMP or any other free software as well, but Photoshop is more convenient to me. Then I'll just fill the background up on a new layer. Just fix the background. Then take some different high contrast colors that just stand out a bit and are easily readable. I can't really explain much here, but the text should be big and readable, also colorful and with much contrast, so the people who see the thumbnail just can instantly see it and also instantly see what it's about. But since I don't think my thumbnails are the best anyway, you should not be trying to copy those. I mean, they're not the worst, but definitely not the best either. You'll need to find out what works best for you. It's the same as in the editing of the video itself.
And now you can upload the video and wait for the people's reactions.
Also, an important thing is that you keep your MV clips shorter than 30 seconds, because otherwise the YouTube algorithm will automatically detect your video and give it an automatic copyright claim. You don't get a strike or a channel deleted for it, but I'd rather not have those. That's also why I meant the clips should be maximum 15 seconds long. That's because I use those clips as the background for the next questions, and the questions can also get up to 15 seconds, so I always try to stay in a safe zone and make the clips like a maximum of 25 seconds long. Because YouTube can detect those clips even through a pretty strong blur I use. I just advise looking out for that. But even if you look out for that, in my case, most of my videos get manually detected by, I guess, some representative from YG and Cube. So I still have copyright claims on pretty much every single video. So if you really don't want any copyright claims from anyone, you should honestly make those clips maximum 25 seconds and also not use YG or Cube clips at all. But in my honest opinion, there would be something missing. Very important tip I can give you outside of the video making is that you organize yourself. Put your pictures in one folder, put your thumbnails in one folder, put your videos in one folder, put your MVs in one folder, put all your finished stuff in one folder. This will make your workflow easier and your learning way, way faster. And I know, since you will put all your time and effort in your channel, you would want people to see those videos. So how do we achieve that? There's one big rule everyone will tell you. Be consistent with your uploads. Not like me at the moment. If you consistently bring out your videos, people will subscribe to you, watch more of your videos, and also YouTube in general will recommend your videos to other people who watch similar videos. That will not happen if you just upload one video. So don't be sad if your first three videos don't get the views you expected. If you constantly keep on working on your channel and do your thing, I can guarantee you, you will be rewarded. If you just learned a little bit from this video, I'm super happy. And if you're serious about this and starting out a YouTube channel, send me your first finished video and I'll watch it and try to give you some tips to improve. So have fun making your own videos, and if you have any questions, just ask, I can answer in the comments. Have a nice day.